great pleasure to welcome Reverend Father Thomas, General Manager of All Mount Carmel Schools, our Reverend Director Father Johnson and Father John. I request all of you please stand up and welcome them with a big round of applause. Celebration makes life creative and active. If you think positively, sound becomes music, movement becomes dance, smile becomes laughter, mind becomes meditation, and life becomes a celebration. With these words, a very fresh and charm morning and a very warm welcome to Reverend General Manager Father Thomas, Reverend Director Father Johnson Matthew, Honorable Father John, respected Principal Sister Tiny Thomas, dear teachers and my loving students, on the auspicious day of the feast celebration of Father Johnson and Father John, wishing you a very happy feast day, dear fathers. A feast is a celebration, a day dedicated to a particular saint. So today, we are going to celebrate the feast of Saint John the Evangelist, chosen to be the patron of literature. He was called by Jesus Christ to be his beloved disciple. In honor of the feast of Saint John, we celebrate the feast day of our beloved fathers, Reverend Father Johnson and Father John. We are privileged to have you with us, dear fathers. Your presence makes a difference in our lives. As priests, the chosen people of God, we always receive your blessings. May we learn from Saint John the Evangelist how to walk wisely from his examples of faith, dedication, worship, and love. Once again, wishing you a very happy feast day, dear fathers. Let's gear up for an outstanding beginning of the function by remembering the Lord, our Creator. To evoke the blessings of the Almighty and to purify and prepare the state by offering prayers in the form of dance, I would like to call on the stage our students for the prayer dance.
Thank you.
cheer and great welcome makes a merry feast. Now I would like to invite Mrs. Reena for introduction and welcome speech.
A very warm good morning, one and all present here. Today we have gathered here to rejoice the celebration of the feast day of our Honorable Director, Reverend Father Johnson Matthew, and our Honorable Administrator, Reverend Father John. First of all, on behalf of entire MCS family, I wish you a very happy feast day, dear fathers. The word feast does not mean a large meal, typically a celebratory one, but instead an annual religious celebration and a day dedicated to a particular saint. According to Catholic Church, Saint John the Evangelist, the beloved disciple, was the youngest of the apostles and the third to be admitted to Jesus' privileged inner circle. John the Evangelist was chosen to be the pattern of literature in the mural pictures. It is the name traditionally given to the author of the Gospel of John. Feast day celebration makes the dedication and devotion to accomplish God's mission. It's my pleasure to start this auspicious occasion by heartily welcoming everybody. Firstly, I wholeheartedly welcome Reverend Father Thomas, General Manager of Mount Carmel Schools. We are really blessed to have you, dear Father, an eminent personality among us on this special day. Hearty welcome, dear Father. I also welcome our dynamic director, Reverend Father Johnson Matthew. Father, your presence makes us very happy. You are really a guiding spirit for us. Your guidance and support prove that you are a great leader. Welcome, Reverend Father. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to our Administrator, Reverend Father Johnson. I express my sincere gratitude to the Almighty for his gift of Reverend Father to this institution. Welcome, dear Father. Now it's my profound honor to welcome our Honorable Principal, Sister Tiny Thomas. Sister, you are truly the idol of knowledge, experience and inspiration to all of us. Welcome, dear sister. I also welcome our cheerful and sportive sisters, Sister Sarita and Sister Sumita. Welcome, dear sisters. Now I welcome the incredible teaching staff who is an integral part of this institution. They work endlessly to shape young lives and make them good citizens of society. I also welcome our hardworking and responsible non-teaching staffs. Last but not least, I welcome all the glittering faces. Obviously, my loving students, the bright future of the country. Now, once again, I wish you a very happy feast day, dear fathers. May your day filled with festivities and feast. All your dreams come true. God bless you with good health and prosperity. Thank you.
Thomas to come on the stage and convey her greetings to dear fathers. Students, give a big round of applause.
Good morning, one and all. Special festive greetings. Special festive greetings to Father Johnson, our director, and Father John, the administrator. May the festivities of this day make your feast day memorable and joyful one. Many are not quite sure why we celebrate feast days of the fathers and not the birthdays. So I thought I shall just brief you on this. A birthday signifies the day that we are born, but feast day signifies the name that we carry. Our fathers, Father Johnson and Father John, has got their names from a Christian saint, Saint John. As mentioned in the Bible, he was referred as the beloved follower of Jesus. He was a young man with a lot of knowledge and talents. But he chose to live his life and use his talents to give glory to God. He wrote a book in the Bible about the life and works of Jesus. Some of St. John's outstanding qualities were his simplicity combined with ecstatic thoughts, his loving nature combined with immense courage to stand by the truth, to be faithful to the master even when all the other followers deserted him at the cross. Life as a follower of Jesus was never easy for him, but he stood boldly even if it meant death for him. And so later he became the best proclaimer of the word of God. Today, as we celebrate the feast of this patron saint and also that of our fathers, Father Johnson and Father John, we wish that these qualities become part of your lives. During these past few months, we have seen the exuberance they radiate through their simple, silent, loving and concerned ways. It is said, let your actions speak, and if necessary, let it be in words. Their presence is seen in every detail of our school. We pray that in the days to come, you too may stand towering as your patron saint, the eagle that flies higher than all. Let your thoughts be so higher, but yet focused on the smallest details of the ground. On behalf of MCS Balachar, I stand to wish you, dear fathers, all the festivities of your feast and our prayers and well wishes that in the days to come, you may be able to imitate your patron saint. Thank you very much. Happy feast.
Thank you so much, sister, for your valuable words. Dance is the joy of moment and the heart of life. Any kind of dancing is better than no dancing at all. Now, students of class 1st and 2nd will entertain you with their lovely dance performance.
Hey, blessings. Good morning to you. My dear Feastarians, Father Johnson, the director of Mount Gama School, Bellachore, Father John, the administrator, and Honorable Principal, Reverend Sisters, and my esteemed staff and dear students. Because you mentioned many a times about the beloved disciple of Jesus, I was just thinking about where can I connect with beloved disciples in our Punjabi culture. You must have heard about the Panj Pyare. Have you heard?
Yes.
You know their names? Panj Pyare? At least one or two names? Five favorite disciples of which Guru? Guru Gobind Singh. So they were Sahib Singh, Dharam Singh, Himmat Singh, Moh Kam Singh, and Daya Singh. I think if my Punjabi culture lessons were all right, these are the five names. Why they were selected? Because the Guru, he needed people who are always willing to give their head, okay, if needed. So these five disciples were selected to be always ready at the command of their Guru to give their lives. You get the point? Marne ke liye har samay tayar rehne ke liye in panj pyaron ko Guruji ne select kiya tha, chun liya tha. You got the point? So today we are celebrating Saint John, the beloved disciple, and he is called the beloved disciple because he was always ready to die, to stand with his master Jesus. So John was only a disciple, a chela, a shishya, a disciple, one who is following his master. So this seems very amusing and enriching for all of us today. How can we become the disciple, the beloved disciple? So we are celebrating today our beloved father's feast day. They also have given their lives for and through Carmelite Charitable Society to our entire Punjab. In Father Log, Yaham Jo Mahjood Hai. So they are coming from different other places. They were serving here in Punjab, some other institutes. Father Johnson was in Kakkon, Hoshiarpur. Father John was in UP, in Muradnagar, before coming here. They were serving different places. So we are being sent to serve a few time in the society with the students, with the different tasks, with the different responsibilities. So let's give them a big round of applause for their service. And they are doing this service voluntarily, okay? Free of cost. They are getting salary, but the salary will go again to the society. So they are doing a lifelong committed voluntary service. So they deserve a big round of applause. More louder. Because you know, these days we don't get anybody free of cost. Free service kahin milta hai? We don't get. we get paid for everything and anything. And these young men have given their life for Jesus. Because of their love of Jesus, they have said, yes, we are willing to serve the society. We are willing to be priest, religious priest. And they have opted for this. So they are also, if not panch pyare, at least do pyare. Do pyare hamare beech mein. So I take this opportunity, I came casually. It happened to be. And since it's their feast day, I thought that it is also my responsibility to make use of this occasion, to wish them and to share the joy, and they invited me. And thank you for the same. And along with you, the entire staff and management of the school, and you, dear beloved children of Mount Carmel School, Bellachore, let's give them all the praise. Let's give them always a smiling face as you see them walking around the corridor, up and down, right from the morning till evening, sometime, you know, guiding us, sometime instructing us, sometime correcting us. And it is their love, their belongingness, their responsibility that they show through their collaboration, through their generosity, through their gentleness to give their time for all of us. So I, from the part of the management of the society, would like to extend my personal thanks to you, Father Johnson and Father John, for being with us always. And more than that, both of them are friends to me. I have that freedom with both of them to share and tell anything whatsoever. And that is, I think, the bond of relationship that we enjoy in the society. More than my colleagues and we work together, we are like you, you know, I may be an elder brother, they are to me like younger brothers. So thank you for your presence in the congregation, and thank you for sharing the priesthood, the ministerial priesthood, because we call ourselves priest. Priest means to serve the people of God and to serve the entire humanity. Every people of all religion are people of God. Whatever may be your religion, maybe one of us may be Hindu, some of us may be Muslim, some of us may be Christian, who whatsoever may be, we serve God in all the religion. And mostly within this Punjab, we share more common thoughts as minority religions. So thank you for holding this function in honor of these two great gentlemen and celebrating. And I really enjoyed the scintillating and magical performance of our tiny tots. I was just thinking, when I was a small kid, I couldn't dance like that. Maybe at least today, I may like to dance if I had that opportunity, I think. And they, without any problem, you know, they were coming here and without having any, you know, stage fear, they were, you know, expressing their dance, you know, when the movements become, you know, a little more magical, it becomes dance. And they were at their best. And I would like to congratulate the teaching staff, especially those who taught them the dancing steps, because they must have taken a long time to teach them, these small tiny kids, at least to line up. I think it will take days to just to start them in line. So a big clap to the staff who taught them. And you see, now those, you know, the big kids, those who are from 5th standard onwards, will be thinking, you see, our teachers have not done anything to us. No, they are working with us. It's very difficult to manage small, tiny tots, you know. And our general staff from the kindergarten section, they are working hard, more than the senior teachers, I would say. For me, they are the foundation of our entire school. And a big round of applause once again to the KG teachers. So patient, motherly, gentle, to tune them, to take care of our small, tiny tots. And again, all of you who have put up so wonderful program, and we went around the classrooms and we saw your handiworks there, your artistic creations, your paintings, your candles, they are all, you know, very outstanding in their construction as well as in their designing, and a big round of applause to the students who did them all. And thank you very much. So let's also try, how can I become today in our society, today in our cultural, historical context, how can I become a beloved to the family, to the school, and to the entire nation? That's my message. And that is my prayer during this Christmas for all of us. Thank you.
Amount of respect, even if they are different from your own. The purpose of religion is to control yourself, not to criticize others. Now the students of class 9 will teach us a very valuable lesson through their act. So welcome the students of class 9 with a big round of applause.
आप सभी यहाँ एकत्रित हुए हैं हमारी रचनात्मक दक्षता को देखने के लिए. हम बच्चे जिसे आप समाज की आदर्शिला मानते हैं, देश का भविष्य मानते हैं, मैं आपसे पूछता हूँ कि क्या दिया है इस देश ने हमें? एक घिसा पिटा भूतकाल और एक ना के बराबर वर्तमान. यह दे रहे हैं आप हमें, है कोई जवाब, है कोई जवाब, है कोई जवाब? जी नहीं, इसका जवाब आप लोगों के पास नहीं होगा, क्योंकि इसे किसी धर्म, सरकार या ज्ञानी ने नहीं, आप लोगों ने ही बनाया है। आइए देखते हैं इसका एक नमूना।
मैं हूँ अपने अब्बू का बेटा अली।
मैं हूँ सरदार राजिंदर सिंह का पुत्र सरदार पुनीत सिंह।
मैं हूँ पंडित शास्त्री का बेटा दिवांश।
I am married the daughter of Mr. Peter.
मान गए होंगे ना आप लोग।
मैं हूँ अपने अब्बू का बेटा अली।
मैं हूँ सरदार राजिंदर सिंह का पुत्र सरदार पुनीत सिंह।
मैं हूँ पंडित शास्त्री का बेटा दिवांश।
I am married the daughter of Mr. Peter.
क्यों, फिर से मान गए होंगे ना आप लोग। लेकिन एक मजे की बात पता है, ना ही कोई अली है, ना ही कोई पुनीत है, ना ही कोई दिवांश है और ना ही कोई मैरी है। हम सब के खून का रंग लाल है, इसीलिए हम सब हैं
हिंदू,
हम सब हैं
सिख,
हम सब हैं
मुस्लिम,
हम सब हैं
ईसाई
और उससे पहले हम सब हैं
इंसान।
देखिए, ऐसे समाज की कल्पना की थी हमने और आपने इसे क्या बना दिया है। आइए देखते हैं इसे एक नाटक के माध्यम से।
हेलो, हाँ जी, मैं करीम बोल रहा हूँ। किससे बात करनी है आपको? अच्छा, दादी से। दादी जान, आपके लिए फोन आया है।
हाँ, आ रही हूँ, क्या बात है?
आपके लिए फोन आया है।
हेलो, हाँ जी, कौन बोल रहा है? अच्छा, बहू के भाई बोल रहे हो, क्या बात है बेटा, सब खैरियत तो है ना? क्या बहू के बेटा हुआ है? सच्ची बोल बेटा, तूने मेरी जिंदगी की सबसे बड़ी ख्वाहिश पूरी कर दी। जीता रहे बेटा, चल ठीक है, मैं रखती हूँ। नवीसा, कहाँ हो, जल्दी आओ।
अरे आ रही हूँ दादी जान, क्या हुआ, क्यों चिल्ला रही हो?
एक खुशखबरी है, कुमार के बेटा हुआ है।
क्या सच्ची में दादी जान? ये तो बहुत खुशी वाली बात है।
हाँ, जाओ जाकर मिठाई लेकर आओ।
जी दादी।
और तुम कुमार को फोन लगाओ। अरे कहाँ हो सब लोग, जल्दी आओ।
क्या हुआ दादी जान?
एक खुशखबरी है, कुमार के बेटा हुआ है।
अरे ये तो बहुत खुशी वाली बात है।
हाँ, अपना मुंह मीठा करो।
लो, कुमार भाई भी आ गए।
नमस्ते दादी।
जीता रहो बेटा, लो अपना मुंह मीठा करो।
नमस्ते। नमस्ते। कैसे हैं भाईजान? कैसे हैं?
बधाई हो भाईजान।
बधाई हो कुमार भाई।
ये लीजिए मौलवी साहब।
वालेकुम सलाम। वालेकुम सलाम मौलवी साहब।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
ये लीजिए मौलवी साहब, काफी समय बाद मेरे घर में खुशी की इल्कारी गूंजी है, इसीलिए मैं ये चद्दर चढ़ाने आया हूँ। शुक्रिया मौलवी साहब।
नहीं सहेंगे, नहीं सहेंगे,
अत्याचार नहीं सहेंगे,
नहीं सहेंगे, नहीं सहेंगे,
अत्याचार नहीं सहेंगे।
अरे क्या हुआ, क्यों लड़ना चाहते हो तुम लोग?
तुम लोगों ने हमारे चार भाइयों का खून किया है, इसका बदला हम किससे लें?
अगर किसी से कोई गुनाह हुआ है तो उसकी सजा कानून देगा, चाहे वो हिंदू हो या मुसलमान।
नहीं नहीं, नहीं हम कुछ नहीं सुनेंगे।
देखो भाइयों, मैं भी एक हिंदू हूँ, मेरी मानो यहाँ पर खून खराबा और झगड़ा अच्छा नहीं होगा, चुपचाप घर वापस लौट जाओ।
अगर तू हिंदू होता तो तू इस तरफ खड़ा होता, उस तरफ नहीं।
अरे ये अल्लाह की दरगाह है, यहाँ पर लोगों की मन्नतें पूरी होती हैं, तुम लोग यहाँ खून खराबा करना चाहते हो?
नहीं नहीं हम कुछ नहीं सुनेंगे। भाइयों हमला।
मेरे साईं रे, साईं रे, झूठी माया का झूठा है जिया रे।
अरे ये कैसी आवाजें आ रही हैं?
कुछ नहीं दादी जान, वो हिंदू भाई और मुसलमान भाइयों के बीच किसी बात को लेकर दंगे हो गए।
मेरा कुमार वो भी उसी तरफ गया है ना?
जी दादी जान, आप चिंता ना करें, मौलवी साहब उन्हें बहुत अच्छे से जानते हैं, वो उन्हें कुछ नहीं होने देंगे। चलिए हम अंदर चलते हैं।
हम सबका ये नारा है,
मुस्लिम धर्म हमारा है,
हम सबका ये नारा है,
मुस्लिम धर्म हमारा है।
अली भाई जान, ये उसी कुमार का मल्ला है जिसने हमारी दरगाह के आगे दंगे करवाए थे?
नहीं, मैं भी एक सच्चा मुसलमान हूँ और मेरा दिल ये कहता है कुमार भाई ऐसा कर ही नहीं सकते।
कर सकते नहीं, उसने ये कर डाला है।
मैं देखता हूँ मेरे भाई का कौन हाथ लगाता है।
भाइयों हम
मेरे साईया रे, साईया रे, झूठी माया का झूठा है जिया रे। हो अब किस दिशा जाऊं, कित मैं बसरा पाऊं।
करीब बेटा कहाँ हो तुम? करीब करीब बेटा कहाँ हो तुम? करीब करीब उठो करीब बेटा, क्या हुआ तुम्हें? करीब उठो करीब बेटा, क्या हुआ तुम्हें? करीब
करीब मेरे भाई कहाँ हो तुम? करीब करीब ये क्या हुआ तुम्हें मेरे भाई? उठ मेरे भाई, तुझे कुछ नहीं हो सकता, उठ करीब। नहीं, मार दिया और इन सबको भी मार दिया, क्या कसूर था इनका? कोई कसूर नहीं था इनका, इन सब में सारा कसूर सिर्फ इस समाज का है, हमारा हंसता खेलता परिवार उजाड़ दिया। माँ क्या तुम ठीक हो?
हाँ मैं ठीक हूँ। जिस माँ का बेटा करीम जैसा हो उसे भला कभी कुछ हो सकता है क्या? नहीं, कभी नहीं।
अगर यह सब ऐसे ही चलता रहा तो खत्म हो जाएगा यह समाज, कुछ नहीं बचेगा, कुछ भी नहीं बचेगा, और इसका जिम्मेवार होगा यह समाज।
धर्म के नाम पर लड़ना पागलपन है, और इस पागलपन से बचना ही मानवता के लिए लाभदायक है।
सभी धर्म एक समान है, लेकिन मानवता सबसे बड़ा धर्म है, पर आजकल का मनुष्य मानवता भुलाकर एक दूसरे का खून का प्यासा बना हुआ है, इसलिए हमें मानवता का ही रास्ता अपनाना चाहिए, इसमें हम सबका भला है।
न जाने इन धर्मों के कारण कितने युद्ध हुए होंगे और कितने लोगों ने अपना परिवार खोया होगा, इसलिए हमारा आप सबसे निवेदन है कि कृपया इन धर्मों के नाम पर भेदभाव करने की जगह ये चीज हमेशा याद रखें कि इन धर्मों से पहले हम एक इंसान थे, हैं और हमेशा रहेंगे।
दुनिया बनाई मैंने हाथों से, मिट्टी से नहीं जज्बातों से, फिर रहा हूँ ढूंढता मेरे निशान है कहाँ, मेरे निशान है कहाँ, मेरे निशान
Respected Father Thomas Maratiparayan, GM of Mount Garma Schools and President of CCS, Reverend Father Johnson Matthew, Director, Principal, Sister Tiny Thomas, Sister Sumida and Sarita, dear teachers and dear loving students. You have heard enough and more about the feast. I think by this time we already understood what is feast meant. It is simply when we make our final commitment to God, we take one saint as our heavenly patron, that is Saint John the Apostle. And the feast day actually falls on 27th of this month. And one or another reason we just anticipate and celebrate today with you in Mount Carmel family. When we go through the Gospel of Saint John, we see the love of God, the love of neighbor. And Jesus himself taught that, love your neighbor as you love oneself. Love your neighbor as you love oneself. And this is really recreated or enacted here in this ground. because you love both of us, Father Johnson and myself, and that love you put forward here. And I know how much hard work you have done, and the time and energy you spent for this day to make it beautiful and memorable. Last 2-3 days it was foggy, and I saw really you are practicing here, and the rehearsal, etc. I could hear from my room. Dear students, I really thank you for your hard work, your energy and time that you spent for this beautiful day. And you really deserve a big round of applause. Thank you so much, dear students. And the teachers who are behind this program, as Father Thomas told, it is very difficult to give practice to the children as they are small. And I don't know how much time you spent behind this program, and the hard work, energy, and everything. Finally, you could do well. You could do, make use of the talents of the children to perform today well. And I thank you for your cooperation and your energy, time, and everything. And also our sister Tiny Thomas, who is always guiding together with her sisters, Sister Sumida and Sarida. They are guiding each one of you, and because of their hard work, because her time, energy, and everything, you could to perform well. As said, dear sisters, thank you so much for your hard work, your love, your concern for both of us. Once again, I thank you for your hard work, for your time, energy, and everything, whatever you have rendered to us. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much, Father, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. Today is a day of celebration, and any celebration without cake is just a meeting. So I would like to invite Reverend Director Father Johnson and Father John for cake cutting ceremony.
Thank you. Father Johnson. I am also much obliged to have Reverend Father John
with us. And we are so blessed seeing you, Father, together in this special day. Thank you, Father. My deepest thanks is for Sister Tiny for making our school shining by organizing such kind of event and allowing us to be the best that we could be. Thank you, Sister, for expressing such kind of faith in us. Thanks a lot. I would also like to thank Sister Sarita and Sister Sumita for being supportive all the time. Thank you, sisters. My gratitude will not be complete without expressing thanks to Sir Puneet for leading and inspiring us to make our efforts the best. Thank you, sir, for your ever-ready support to us. I would like to thank all my worthy teachers for their moral support and constant hard work to make this event marvelous. My gratitude knows no bounds, so my next thanks to all the participants for their display of huge talent. We enjoyed a lot their rhythmic performances. Thank you for your active participation and stunning performances. I also like to the audience for their presence. At last, my thanks goes to our non-teaching staffs for their support and hard work behind the stage. Your work a lot for the smooth functioning of this auspicious day. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I hope all of you have enjoyed a lot. Once again, wishing you a very happy feast day, dear fathers. May God bless you with all your wishes and give us strength to go on doing better for the upliftment of this institution and the entire society. Thank you so much.